Capacitance of a spherical capacitor. A spherical capacitor consists of a solid or a hollow spherical conductor surrounded by another concentric hollow spherical conductor, as I have shown here. Let I say inner sphere has radius r1, outer sphere has radius r2, and Q charge is given to inner sphere like this. Let me draw it. Here I give the Q charge. All of you know this will be uniformly distributed. I say it is Q charge like this. Then all of you know on inner wall of outer surface minus Q will be, because whole flux has to terminate here, and outer surface no charge. So I say it is minus Q on the inner side. Is it clear? Now, potential difference between these two conductors, if I write V equal to V1 minus V2. I say inner one is conductor number 1 and outer is the conductor number 2. Then all of you know second conductor is grounded, so potential is 0, so V1 minus V2 is only V1. Is it clear? Now what is V1? Potential due to charge plus Q on the R1, KQ upon R1. Potential due to the charge minus Q on the R2, minus KQ upon R2. You can calculate yourself. For the capacitance, you will say C equal to Q by V. And when you put this, all of you will get this result, 4 pi epsilon naught R1 R2 upon R2 minus R1. That you have to solve yourself. Now, if I say R2 tends to infinite, then what is capacitance? C equal to 4 pi epsilon naught R1. It means we can say an isolated sphere can be looked upon as a spherical capacitor whose outer sphere is at infinite. One more thing I want to tell. Second situation. Okay. Just a minute. Yeah. No, it's working. If I say both R1 R2 are very large, like this, and I say R2 minus R1 equal to D, then I can write 4 pi epsilon naught R1 R2 is 4 pi, or epsilon naught, leave it, we can calculate 4 pi R1 R2, it is 4 pi R square, like this. I think it should be 2 pi R, yeah, there is a mistake, yeah. 2 pi r whole square. This should be, just a minute. This should be, I think you can rectify it. 2 pi something like this. Oh, sorry, it should be 4 pi r square. Yeah. It should be the area. No. I can write C is epsilon naught A by D. Same expression as the capacitance of parallel plate capacitor. So, all of you have. All of you are agree with this result? 4 pi epsilon naught R1 R2 upon R2 minus R1. Let me show in the next slide this result. Okay, I want to clear one more thing here. Can you think it is a series combination of number of parallel plate capacitors? So I am writing here. Think it as a series combination of parallel plate capacitor, of parallel plates. Okay, let I consider an elementary capacitor which can be treated as a parallel plate capacitor because separation between the plates is very small. Hence, plate can be assumed to be plane. So, I assume it. एट अ डिस्टेंस एक्स ऑफ विड्थ डी एक्स. ऑफ कोर्स इट इज इन सराउंडिंग होल सरफेस हियर एंड दिस इज होल सरफेस हियर. नाउ व्हाट इज द कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ दिस एलिमेंट्री कैपेसिटर, टेल मी. कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ दिस एलिमेंट्री कैपेसिटर, यू आर एज्यूमिंग पैरेलल प्लेट. You will say small capacitance DC can be written as, or for, of course for parallel plate capacitor we know C equal to epsilon naught A by D. You can say epsilon naught, what is area, 4 pi x square, very true, sphere, upon distance between the plate is dx. Now you will say what we can assume, all such elemental capacitor are connected in series, hence I integrate for the net capacitance 1 upon C equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3, I can say 1 upon DC. So I put the value of the DC. What I got right? 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught integration dx upon x square, and x is varying from r1 to r2, and when you integrate it, I am sure you will get exactly same result which we got in the last slide, like this. Now one more thing I want to tell you. In this situation, inner sphere is grounded. Okay. Firstly, again we assume, suppose we give a charge Q to this outer surface, outer sphere, whole sphere, and we all know this inner one is the positive potential, earth has to transfer some charge. So suppose I say earth has transferred charge definitely minus Q1, suppose I assume. If I write potential of the inner sphere, what I will say, potential of the inner sphere is written as K Q1 upon A plus K Q upon B, and this inner sphere is grounded, so this potential should be zero, and you will calculate value of the Q1 is given by minus QA upon B. Of course you have taken negative. Why negative? Because otherwise potential cannot be zero, because it is already in the positive potential. Now you just think it in this way. This is inner sphere, this is outer sphere, and I say this inner one is grounded, like this. This is grounded. Ye grounded. Okay. Radius of course same, that is small a and that is small b. Is it clear? Here I say charge is minus Q1, and value of the minus Q1 you people know very well. Then definitely on this wall there should be plus Q1. The charge on plus Q1. The charge on this sphere should be only Q. It means on the outer surface charge is Q minus Q1. Now you have to think, and please keep this thing in mind also. What we observe that charge is also present on the outer surface of the outer sphere. So given arrangement can be taken as parallel combination of two capacitors. Two capacitors out of this, one is due to the minus Q1 and plus Q1. It is clear to all of you. And second capacitor is formed by the outer sphere, whose second surface can be taken as infinite. We can consider it as the isolated sphere. It means if I say due to plus Q1 and minus Q1, I write the capacitance. I will say C1 can be written as फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट ए बी अपॉन बी माइनस ए, एंड वॉट इज सी टू डू टू द आइसोलेटेड स्फेयर, इट इज फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट बी, एंड वेन आई एड दिस बिकॉज सी इक्विवेलेंट इन द पैरेलल कैन बी रिटन एज सी वन प्लस सी टू, डेफिनेटली ऑल ऑफ यू विल गेट द रिजल्ट विच वी नो वेरी वेल, फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट बी स्क्वायर अपॉन बी माइनस ए, like this. Now, one more method I want to tell you. See, one more way here, one more approach to strengthen your concept. In the left hand side, I am drawing the diagram when it is not grounded. This radius is small a, this radius is small b. Okay? And I say I give the charge q on the outer sphere. Like this. Now what I am doing, I am grounding the inner one. And I say I want the charge on this surface number one, charge on this surface number 2 and charge on this surface number 3. I know you people can easily calculate. You will say charge on surface number 1 can be written as minus qa upon b. Charge on surface number 2 is given by plus qa upon b. And charge on surface number 3, if you will calculate, you will get q p minus a upon b. I hope it is clear. Now, energy density, energy per unit volume, people know, half epsilon naught e square. Now, if I am able to calculate the energy due to this combination, then by equating that energy with half Cv square or half Q square by C, I will calculate the net capacitance. Firstly, I want the electric field. So, I think from the Gauss law, if I want to write the electric field at a distance r which is less than a, what you will say? Less than a distance, which charge is responsible? Only q1. And what is the value of the q1? Qa upon b. So what I write? It can be written as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q1, I can write it q A upon B KQ upon R square. If I want to write electric field at a distance R is greater than B outside, what is net charge? Q1 plus Q2 will be cancelled, only Q3 will remain. So, if only Q3 will remain, what I will say? 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, what is the value of the Q3? That is Q B minus A upon B dot 1 upon R square. Now, we are able to know the electric field which exists between the shells as well as outside the shells. Now, I have to integrate and I have to calculate total energy of the system. Again, I am telling you, total energy of the system is the sum of the energy in the electric field between inner shells and outer shells, outside of the shells. Like, now I use this formula. I take any elemental shell of radius r, thickness dr, anywhere, it doesn't matter, always. So, volume of that elemental shell can be written as 4 pi r square dr. Now, I am writing energy. you. Firstly, I am moving from small a to b. Reason? Because I have to discuss that energy. Is it clear? What concept I will use? I have to use the formula r is less than a. When I use that formula, what I will say? 1 by 2 epsilon naught. What is e square? I can put this e square here. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught qa upon b 1 upon r square whole square into, I am leaving for you, into volume 4 pi r square dr. Outside. Now I am moving outside. When I move outside, for r is greater than b, I am moving from b to infinite. Again, half epsilon naught e square. This is the e square, this value, into 4 pi r square dr. So we know the electric field between this plate, that is, this is the electric field, r is less than b. Okay. And when we know the electric field outside, that also we have calculated. Now I am leaving this whole integration for you. You please pause the video, and after that you solve it, and I am sure you will get this result. Q square upon 8 pi epsilon naught b minus a upon b square, like this. And what is the standard result for the energy of the capacitor? Half Q square upon C. When you compare it, I am sure you will get exactly same result as we have discussed, like this. So I have given you energy method also, I have given you electric field method also. You can use any method in the numericals. Capacitance of a sphere capacitor. Suppose there are two spherical capacitors. They are far away because I have written L is greater than A and B. No interaction. Because if interaction is there, then I have to consider energy concept. So I will discuss in the next part. If we transfer a charge Q from sphere B to sphere A, and you say here the charge comes plus Q, of course here the charge will be minus Q. First, you tell me what is the capacitance of the system, Q upon high potential minus low potential. We will say C equal to Q upon potential of A. Just a minute. Potential of A, you will say KQ upon A minus potential of B minus KQ upon B. You solve it. I am sure you will get this result. 4 pi epsilon naught AB upon A plus B. So just pause the video and solve yourself. Capacitance of the shell which carry equal and opposite charge separated by distance d. But now you are not writing that d is greater than a and b. Interaction is there. First of all of you write potential energy of the system. Okay. I will say, I know the formula kq square by 2r, so it is 2a. It is clear? Then energy of this k and minus q square, again I will say, okay, one step I write here, k q square upon 2b. Then interaction energy k q1 q2 upon r, that is d. When I solve it, what I get? K q square by 2 1 upon a plus 1 upon b minus 2 upon d. Okay, now you equate with standard formula q square by 2c. You will get c equal to 4 pi epsilon naught 1 upon a plus 1 upon b minus 2 upon d. Here you can think, which we have done earlier. If I say d tends to infinite, like this, then what is the capacitance? You will say 4 pi epsilon naught 1 upon a plus 1 upon b, which we have done in the last slide. Is it? So, but one more thing I want to tell you, one more method I want to tell you. Please look at that method also. In this method, we will use the electric field concept like this. Firstly, suppose I think there is a point P and this distance is given by R from this side. Of course, from this side it will be d minus r. Or if you calculate the electric field at point P due to the sphere number 1 and sphere number 2, you will say it is written as k q upon r square plus k q upon d minus r whole square. Is it? I am not writing minus because electric field we have to add the directions, both the directions toward right hand side. Now I know the formula dv equal to minus e dot dr. Okay, so I calculate, I integrate it. dv, I want to calculate the potential difference between the sphere A and B. Okay, and r is varying from surface to the other surface A to this r is varying d minus b, limit is d minus b. You put the value of the e is this here, you integrate this, but integration when you calculate it, I hope you will get the relation like this, Va minus Vb equal to kq 1 upon a plus 1 upon b minus 1 upon d minus a minus 1 upon d minus b, like this. Now here you have to assume one thing, d is greater than a and d is greater than b. So this can be written only 1 upon d, this can be written only 1 upon d, and when you calculate it, you will get potential difference is given by kq 1 upon a plus 1 upon b minus 2 upon d. Now use C equivalent equal to q upon v and you will calculate that. You will get same result as we have discussed earlier, 4 pi epsilon naught 1 upon a plus 1 upon b minus 2 upon d. So I have discussed a number of approaches. Of course, numerical will be little bit tougher compared to these approaches. So I will discuss some more depth in this concept in the numerical part. Now we'll go to the next segment. Capacitance of cylindrical capacitor.